Okay, now we're going to make fried steak. You can use whichever cut of steak you and your family feel comfortable with. Some people choose a London broil, which is a tougher kind of a ground beef. Some people like to use ground beef, you know, that people would use for hamburger. I'm using eye of ground because that's what my family prefers, but you should use whatever works for you, whatever is on sale at the grocery store. Most important thing is add a tablespoon or so of vinegar, because that's going to tenderize your meat and give it a lot of flavor. No more than a tablespoon, though. You want to make sure you moisten both sides of each if you use a fillet. This isn't necessary if you're using the ground steak, but if you're using a cut steak, as I am, you definitely want to use the vinegar. Okay. So now that the steaks are moistened, I'm going to season salt. And once we completely season them, this is onion powder, garlic powder, and black pepper. Very simple, just gonna lightly flour each fillet. I know you say lightly, but we're gonna shake that off. So don't worry. That's not light. And then we're gonna turn it over and do the same thing to the other side. And again, exact same seasoning, doesn't matter which order. Just want to make sure that you cover both sides with seasoning. That was the onion powder. We're back with the black pepper, garlic, granulated garlic. Don't use garlic salt because you're going to want to control your own salt. So just make the seasoned salt be the only salt. Don't use onion salt. One salt will do you. That way you can control. And again, with my light flour dusting, right? If that's light, what's heavy? Heavy is when you make an egg or milk wash and dip the flour in it and it makes it real heavy. But what you'll see here, that once you turn it over, see that was the first one, not much flour left on there. I've heated up over there in the skillet about a half inch of oil, vegetable oil. And we're going to add the fillets to that. Can you see that the flour is gone? So now it's light, right? Okay. Oh, great. Now I'm all powdery. You haven't fried stuff until you get flour all over your pan. Okay. And we'll take the four steaks over here and lay them into the oil. Oil should be getting warm there. I like it to sizzle a little more. It was on 4, so I'm going to turn it to 5. And these cook pretty quickly. You can see that it's hot because the flour is bubbling. But not as hot as I like it. So we're going to heat that up. Looks like our sweet potatoes are done. And we'll let this cook just for a few minutes. When it's brown on one side, you turn it over. When it's brown on that side, we're done. So our steaks are done. We're going to go ahead and plate that up. And the crust is the good part, so I don't like to leave that in the skillet. I actually added a dollop, 1 tablespoon of butter to my string beans because it makes them delicious. If you have a high cholesterol issue, don't add the butter. Just stay with the olive oil. Otherwise, your body knows how to process. If you're not lactose intolerant, dairy. So I love butter. And just a tablespoon will go a long way. So here we have our string beans. And for our friends in New Zealand and in Soul Food LA, we have our candied yams. Brown sugar and cinnamon. And of course, butter. And there we have it with our delicious peach cobbler. Should we place some of that up too? Why not? Alright, our peach cobbler is hot. Oh, and you know, peach cobbler is not anything you cut, it's something you scoop. We're going to scoop it out and add ice cream. Mmm. Looks like peach cobbler to me. There we go. No way really to present peach cobbler. You just eat it, right? So we have that. I have a scoop of ice cream here. Now that is soul food Sunday dinner. We have sweet potatoes, candied yams. We have French style green beans, a country fried steak, and a fresh peach cobbler. Bon appetit.